What's up, freaks? This is Steve Says, episode number 62. We are back at it for the new year, January 1st. Steve Says, what better way to kick off the year? You see it in the headlines. Are those motivational self-help, self-development gurus lying to you? Are you wasting your time with all this goal setting and thinking positive and dreaming of the future stuff that you hear all over the freaking internet? We're going to talk about that today on Steve Says, episode 62. Some people will hate, but most can relate. Bring in the fucking fire every second of every second. Just pulling you up on the second screen. If you have any questions, comments, remarks, and just to get us our sound check. All right, we are good. We are ready to roll. So, you know, Steve says, we're bringing the fucking fire every second of every second. It's, did you set goals in 2000 for this year, 2019? Do you feel good about the 2018 you had? Do you feel good about the upcoming 2019? Are you visualizing your great success for the upcoming year? Or are you just wasting your time doing all this crap that you're hearing that you should be doing? Steve Says is a live show on how to have a no excuses, badass mindset, guiding you to adapt, overcome, and destroy the obstacles preventing your success in your health, your family, and your finances, so that you can stop being a little bitch, get your shit together, and start living life on your own fucking terms. That's what it's all about, so we're gonna break it down today on Steve Says. It's about adapting and overcoming, becoming a better version of yourself, trusting the process, and of course, making no excuses. And we're gonna apply all of that to these New Year resolutions or whatever else you have going on out there. So you have any questions, comments, put them down there below in the comments section. I have you pulled up on a second screen here. We can talk about it. We are rolling. We are rolling live. So send in your questions, comments, you have them. Let's talk. But let's get right to it. Let's get down to it. It's that time of year, freaks. It's the new year. All the New Year's resolutions are going on. That time of year that everyone sets new goals and visualizes their ultimate dreams and they're thinking positive and they're posting a bunch of motivational shit on social media, right? So, I'm inspired with all that stuff. How about you? Are you inspired with all that? I get inspired from it. It's all over the place. So, did you set goals for this year coming up? Do you feel good about this upcoming year coming up because of your positive thinking or your visualizing or your motivation or your journaling or your writing down of your goals? But when it comes down to it, you may be wasting your time doing all that, and we're going to break it down why. Because I see it every day all over Facebook. The gurus, some of which are, you know, legitimate thought leaders in out there in the industry, and then also the so-called fucking gurus, telling you that you need to set the high goals, and you need to think big and dream big. Think positive. Just always think positive. And meditate. Fucking Aum and all this other stuff. Drink more fucking water and stay hydrated and be healthy and all these other different ways of nutrition and all this other stuff, right? They tell you you need to have a clear vision on your why. Why do you do the things you do? What's your reason why you do what you do or why you want these goals? You need to have a clear vision in your head with a mission and a purpose and a cause. This is all the stuff that's fed to us on a daily basis. But is it bullshit? Is it bullshit? We're going to break it down. They tell you, you need to picture it in your mind. And, you know, that's the big secret. Picture it in your mind. If you can believe it, you can achieve it. Sounds like a bunch of bullshit, right? Are all these fucking lies? Is this just a bunch of bullshit? You know, just think positive. Everything happens for a reason. It's just your path, your journey, and all this other stuff. Dream big. Don't be afraid. You can do anything you put your mind to in this upcoming year. Let's just set some New Year's resolutions. Let's set some huge goals. Let's think big. Write your goals down every day. Be grateful. Be grateful for what you have. All right, so worse than all this, we're gonna break this all down. We're going to get into this in a second. But worse than all that, really, now that I'm thinking about it, are the negative perpetrators out there on the internet. Posting all this New Year shit about leaving that trash and negativity behind in the past in the previous year. When, motherfucker, you're the trash that's getting left behind. Those people that are putting all that crap out there. Just because you post a bunch of positive quotes on the freaking internet does not make you a positive person. Just because you talk about an amazing New Year and you know, that you're going to have and all this you're going to do in this new year coming up. And just because you post that, put it on the internet, does not make it true. Does not mean it will happen because you post some shit on the internet. So what you need to leave behind in that past year is all your bullshit, your lies, your procrastination, your blaming of everyone else, your lack of ownership in everything you do, your freaking gossiping, your fakeness, your crying, your whining, your boo fucking who. It's everyone else's fault but your own, victim, bitch, acid, men, mentality and mindset. That's what you need to leave behind in the previous year. That's a side note of what we're talking about. But all that motivation crap of that goes out there of someone that you know that's just the most negative motherfucker, most gossiping person you know, and they post all that stuff. Oh, I'm leaving all the trash and all the negativity behind. You need to take your own advice. That's a side note. But just ditch it, all right? Ditch it, leave it, drop it, and for real, do it for real. Not just posting a bunch of lame-ass pictures of daisies and shit on the internet. That's not going to get you any results. All right, so anyway, so back to the thought leaders and the gurus. Are they lying to us with all they tell us to do about setting goals? Write your goals down. Think big. It's all in your head. Believe and achieve and all this mumbo jumbo higher up in the heavens and screaming from a mountaintop. Freaking motivation, inspiration, getting us fired up for the new year. But I'm here to tell you today, it's a bunch of fucking bullshit. All right, let me explain. I won't say that these are lies or really that's bullshit, but in a way it is if you don't have the rest of the puzzle. Now, these are all great tips, obviously, and things that you probably should be doing. Don't just fucking post about it, but be doing. But they're all missing a few key ingredients. And because a bunch of quotes on freaking social media or pictures of flowers and puppies or goats or a fucking sunshine and some daisies will not get you to your goals. You can think about that shit all you want. It's not going to get you to goals. It's not going to make you lose weight. It's not going to cause you to be happier. It's not going to help you get that job. It's not going to help you make more money or deliver any kind of success just because you post some shit on the internet or just because you wrote it down on a piece of paper or just because you envisioned it at nighttime before you passed off and sleep and all that other crap. A few things are going to be needed. A few pieces to the puzzle are missing to all this shit. And that's having a plan that has some discipline, enthusiasm, and most of all, action. Discipline, enthusiasm, and action. Because what good are setting goals if you don't take action? If you just post a bunch of fucking shit on the internet, what good is setting some goals for this bright, brand new year? Leaving the trash behind, I'm going to do this, I'm going to post all about it on the internet. What good is all these goals if you don't take action on them? If you don't follow through? What good is visualizing your success and all this meditation and thinking about it and picturing it and picturing all the riches that you want to claim that you're going to have in the new year if you don't have the fucking discipline for the long game? It's a marathon, not a sprint. Yes, I think positive all the time in every situation. You need to think positive, but you just can't think positive or just post, you know, for some of those fucking people out there, just post some positive shit on the internet. You need to act positive. You need to put positivity into your actions, into your forward motion is what you need to do. Not just talk about, oh, I'm so positive. But meanwhile, you're this freaking cranky old fucker and complaining all the time and whining with a whole bunch of bullshit. Now, don't be mistaken. Don't make no mistake about this. This shit is not easy. Putting action to your why and operating under your mission and purpose and achieving your goals, whether it's fitness, personal, business, financial, professional, whatever it is, that shit is hard fucking work and it's gonna take time. It's not gonna take some posts on the internet or some fucking meditation or just some positive thinking. That shit's not gonna cut it. Walt Disney, who said the way to get started is to quit talking and begin doing. Now, how simple is that? As simple as it gets, but as deep as it gets right there. Basically, stop fucking talking about it and go do it. Get off your fucking ass. Stop saying how great you are. If you have to tell the world how great you are, if you have to tell the world about all this shit you're gonna do in the next year, you probably ain't that great and you probably ain't doing shit because you're too busy talking about it rather than doing it. If you were doing that shit, it would be noticed and people would see the shit you're doing. You wouldn't have to constantly be telling people, oh, I did this, I'm awesome, my fucking feet don't smell. Motherfucker, your shit stinks. It does. Hate to tell you, hate to break it down. You need to operate to fucking dominate. Operate to dominate, OD, in 2019. That's what you need to fucking do. Make a clear plan, take massive fucking action, and implement that action with discipline, and enthusiasm. That is all it takes. You're going to experience all throughout this year, all throughout your life, you're going to experience the suck factor many times along the way. Shit is going to suck. Shit is not going to go your way. You're going to lose. You're going to fail. You're going to get fucked up. You're going to get fucked over. You're going to get stabbed in the back time and time again by all the people around you. It's just going to happen. Expect it, embrace it, and get used to that shit. It's all part of the process. It's part of the freaking game. It's a game. Life is a fucking game. Life is a playground. It's going to take grit. It's going to take in the trenches, in the weeds, getting your hands fucking dirty in the mud, grinding it out, and actually implementing all those plans that you wrote down and all those goals you wrote down, all that visualizing, all that fucking positive thinking and aum that you fucking did. It's going to take some grit and hard motherfucking work with all that visualization to make all that stuff come true. And all that voodoo and all this other mind shit and all that gratitude and gratefulness and all this other stuff you're giving. It's going to take hard freaking work to make that shit happen. So stop being a little bitch with it. Stop talking about it. Stop posting about it. Go fucking do it. Speaking of being grateful, since I brought that up, the little midget, the little girl told me the other day in school, this is like a week ago, whatever, I just thought of it now. She said, I don't remember, something happened and she got something that she got that they were handing out in school, a color of a crayon, I don't remember what it was. And she asked for a different one. She wanted a different one. I don't even remember the story. But the teacher told her, you get what you get and you don't get upset. And she told me about this. I was, what the fuck is that mean? You get what you get and you don't get upset? If that's your attitude going into 2019, and that's your attitude you let your kids have, and that's your attitude you're teaching the kids, and that's the attitude you're letting teachers tell your kids, you get what you get and you don't get upset, fuck that shit. I told her next time they tell that teacher, no, Mrs. Teacher, I'm sorry, but I am going to get what I deserve. I'm going to get what I fucking work hard for. I'm not going to get what I just planned for and what the luck of the draw gives me. I'm not going to just get what the world gives me and what I think I'm entitled to. I'm going to get what I motherfucking work hard for, what I bust my ass for, what I'm in the trenches for, getting my hands dirty for. That's what I'm going to get. Not get what I get and don't upset, whatever the fuck that saying is. Fuck that. Leave that shit in last year. Not, if that's your mentality in 2019 is fucked. Start making your resolution for 2020 already if that's your attitude and mentality and mindset for 2018. Get what you get. You don't get upset. Fuck that. And if that's what you're teaching little four-year-olds at that point, that goes to show why things are the way they are in some areas. Anyway, back on track. It's all that stuff, all this visualization and goal setting and all this other stuff. It is all just useless fluff and fucking theory if you don't implement it and act on it. You have to act on it. You have to take action. You just need fucking action. You can't just have this mindset either. You can't just think this just one day a year. Oh, it's the new year. Let me just be Mr. fucking positivity, Mr. fucking motivation, Mr. goal setter, Mr. I'm going to do this and that, and then fall off the wagon 2-3 fucking days later. You need to have that. You can't have that mindset one day a year. This needs to be the way you operate every single freaking day. Fuck a New Year's resolution. You need to have a new day's resolution every fucking day of your life. Commit to that for this year. Have a new day resolution. Become a better version of yourself tomorrow than you were today. Today than you were yesterday. Can you kick your own ass from yesterday? Can you outwit your own ass from yesterday? Are you better than yesterday? Can you out-strategize your version of yourself from yesterday? So cut the bullshit. Quit all the pondering and meditating and qualifying and organizing and planning and scheduling and posting and all the fake motivation, mumbo jumbo bullshit and positivity out there on the internet. Instead, just make it fucking happen. You can do anything you put your mind to. Bullshit. You can't do shit you just put your mind to. If you just put your mind to it, you can't do shit. You need to put your mind to it and then take fucking action. So don't go and tell, oh, you could do whatever you put your mind to. It's a fucking lie. These are all lies without following through and taking action. It's all lies. So ask yourself every single day, right now, this minute, did you make actual moves today to move the needle forward towards those goals and towards that visualization and towards that mission and purpose and vision and values that you have in your head that you've been meditating on for all of 2018? And then 2018 comes to an end. What the fuck? I don't have shit. I didn't move forward. I was meditating. I had such positive thinking all year. I posted so many times on Facebook how positive of a motherfucker I am. And yet I'm still overweight, still unhappy, still broke, Still miserable. What happened? I don't get it. I thought I knew the secret. You need to take action on your goals. So ask yourself every day, did you make moves today? Did you take action steps today? Actually moving forward, physical action in the motherfucking trenches action to move the needle forward towards your goals and visualization. You need to operate to dominate. DEA. Operate to dominate with DEA. Discipline, enthusiasm, and action. That's what you need to do, and that's what's going to guarantee your success in 2019. Not just a bunch of posts on the internet. OD, operate to dominate, DEA, discipline, enthusiasm, action. That's what it takes. I guarantee you'll fucking explode in 2019. No excuses.